Hello everybody, praise the Lord. I welcome you all to the online Sunday school service in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We hope that you and your family are doing well. Thank you for joining in today and please share the link of this video to your friends and family so that they might get to know more about Jesus through these videos. So let us all get ready to worship God and understand His word. Before that, let us read a verse from the Bible. Acts chapter 4 verse 12 says, "Salvation is found in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given to mankind by which we must be saved." In this verse, it says that Jesus is the only way to salvation. Salvation means being delivered from sin by faith in Jesus, and that we have to be saved by believing in His name and by believing that He died for us. Let us look to God in prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this day you've given us, O Lord. Thank you, Father, for this time you've given us to know your word and understand your word, O Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord, for your protection in all of us, O Lord Jesus. Yes, O Lord. Thank you, Father, for keeping us safe, O Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father, for your grace and for your blessings on all our online services till now, Father, Lord Jesus. We pray that you continue to bless all our services, O Father, Lord. Father, we pray that we give thanks to you that you are the only way to salvation for us, O Father, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, help us to understand that, O Lord. Father, we pray for all the students, O Lord, and their families, O Lord Jesus. Yes, O Lord. Father, let your protection be on them, O Father, Lord. Yes, O Lord. And help us to understand what your word says, O Father, Lord Jesus. Father, we also pray for all the teachers and volunteers, O Father, Lord, that your protection be on them, O Father, Lord, as they take care of the service, O Lord Jesus. We pray that you help them as they teach us your word, O Father, Lord. We pray for everything, O Lord Jesus, Father, Lord. We pray for the service again, O Father, Lord. Let everything go according to thy plan, O Father, Lord. We thank you for our lives again, O Lord Jesus. In Jesus' most precious and holy name we pray. Amen.
Today's Bible reading is taken from the book of John chapter 14 verses 1 to 4. Jesus the way to the Father. "Do not be worried and upset," Jesus told them. "Believe in God and believe also in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house, and I am going to prepare a place for you. I would not tell you this if it were not so. And after I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to myself, so that you will be where I am. You know the way that leads to the place where I am going." This is the word of God.
Hey kids, there was a time when people who used to travel always carry this roadmap with them. The roadmap used to help them and guide them whenever they miss their way. So today we see that there are many ways to reach our destination, but we need to be careful to know and follow one direction to reach our destination. And we all know that today the roadmaps are obsolete. Thanks to our smartphones and GPS. Because of the smartphones and GPS, we can reach our destination. The only thing what we need to do is we need to key in our address and we need to follow the directions given by the GPS. Only when we follow the directions provided by the GPS, we will be able to reach our destination without any problem. When Adam and Eve disobeyed, they sinned against God. This brought a separation between man and God. To connect back the relationship between man and God, He sent His Son Jesus as a way to heaven. Jesus is like GPS to us. So we need to just follow Him to reach our destination, that is heaven. Today we are going to learn that Jesus is the way, the truth and the life. Before that, let us all rise up to our feet and worship our Lord Jesus Christ.
I lay my life down at your feet. You're the only one I need. I turn to you and you are always there. In troubled times, it's you I see. I put you first, that's all I need. I humble all I am, all to you. One way, Jesus, you're the only one that I could live for. One way,
Praise the Lord, children. Greetings to you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I hope you're all safe at home doing your studies as well as reading your Bibles. As we all heard and sang today, that there is only one way, and that is Jesus. Today, let us know what this means and also when Jesus told this to his disciples. Just before Jesus was arrested to be crucified, he was having his last meal with his disciples. And during that time, Jesus went on to tell what would happen to him and how he would die. So listening to this, the disciples were very worried and upset and confused because Jesus was their best friend and also their teacher. Seeing them sad, Jesus told them to believe in God and also to believe in him. And he went on to tell them that in his Father's house, that is in heaven, there are many rooms, and he was going there to prepare a place for them so that he would come back and take them to be with him forever. And then he told them that they know the way to that place. So Thomas asked Jesus that he doesn't know where Jesus is going, so how will he know the way to the place? So Jesus told him that, "I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father except through me." So let us learn today what Jesus meant by saying that he is the way, the truth, and the life. So firstly, Jesus said that, "I am the way." When God created us, he created us to be with him, but we all chose our own ways to live in this life. The Bible says that we are all lost in our sin. Children, have you ever got lost? That is, you were separated from your parents when you went somewhere and you got so scared looking for them and they were looking for you and finally they found you and you were so happy that you found them. In the same way, we are all lost in this world without God, and God wants to come to us, and he made a way for us and he sent Jesus into this world. Jesus is the heavenly GPS for us. Is he is God's plan for our salvation, because God sent him into this world so that we can be reconnected with God, and he is the only way to heaven. People try various ways to please God, thinking they can go to heaven by doing good works or following certain traditions or having different faiths. But the Bible clearly tells us that Jesus is the only way to heaven. Because Jesus died for our sins, God made a way for us by believing in Jesus and repenting for our sins. When we confess our sins to Lord Jesus, he forgives us our sins and makes us holy to stand before God. And this enables us to live a life of holiness that God wants from us. And ultimately, he leads us to heaven. The second thing that Jesus says is, "I am the truth." So what is truth? Suppose I ask you, what is 2 plus 2? I'm sure you'll all say it is 4. And if I tell you to prove it, you can count it on your fingers and tell me that 2 plus 2 is 4. In the same way, we can know that Jesus is the truth by reading the Bible and knowing more about his life. The life of Jesus proves that he is true, because whatever he said, he did it. And whatever he told, happened. Jesus reveals us the truth about God, and he is the source of all truth. Yes, Jesus is the very word of God that we have. And the Bible reveals us that he is God and he is truth. Jesus said, "I am the life." He is the source of all life because he is the only one who came back to life after death. And he is the one who can give us eternal life. And because Jesus lives, we will also live. When we give our life to Jesus, that is, we make Jesus the most important person in our life, he comes into our heart and stays in our heart, and he will lead us and guide us in the right direction. So children, ask Jesus to come into your heart, and when he comes into your heart, your life will never be the same. He will be with you at all times to guide you and to lead you into all truth.
Answered, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one come to the Father except through me." John 14:6.
So let us pray. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, We thank you, Lord, that you are the way that we need to follow, and you are the truth that we need to believe in, and you are the life that we need to live with. Yes, Lord, I surrender all these children into your hands. Lord, Holy Spirit, come into our hearts and help us and guide us, Lord, to live a life that glorifies your name. In Jesus' most mighty name I pray. Amen. God bless you all, children.
Past 6 weeks, we've been listening about the I am statement of Jesus from the Gospel of St. John. Today, let us summarize that. Before that, the phrase I am is a covenant name of Yahweh. I am means God was and God is and God is to come. Jesus is declaring that he is the I am. That means that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. The first I am statement of Jesus is, I am the bread of life. He meant that he is the one who nourishes and strengthens our spiritual hunger. The bread that Jesus gives us is a life that lasts forever. When Jesus declared that he is the light of the world, he meant that he is the source of light and he is the permanent solution for the darkness to be removed from our life. The third I am statement of Jesus is, I am the door. He meant and emphasized that he is the entry point to be saved from this sin. Jesus is there to protect us, guide us, and care for us. The fourth I am statement of Jesus is, I am the good shepherd. As shepherd lays down his life for the sheep, the same way Jesus came down to this earth and he sacrificed his life so that we can have an abundant life on this earth. As the sheep followed the shepherd, we need to follow Jesus. The fifth I am statement of Jesus is, I am the resurrection and the life. When he declared this, he meant that he has power over the death and key for eternal life. The sixth I am statement of Jesus is, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He is the only path to heaven. He is the spoken word of God. He is the source of both physical and spiritual life. The seventh I am statement of Jesus is, I am the vine. We have to be rooted and be connected to Jesus to bear good fruits in our life.
You can write today's topic and memory verse. Send the picture of the activity and video of the memory verse to the number displayed on the screen. God bless you, kids. Stay safe. Bye.